Hello everybody and welcome. My name is Samer Aoudi and in this video I will introduce the lab environment for CIS2103. First of all, if you're not familiar with virtualization, I highly recommend you pause this video and go watch Introduction to Virtualization and then come back here. Okay, at this point, it is assumed that you understand virtualization. So let us get started. Our physical computers can host a number of virtual computers called virtual machines or VMs. The main issue we face as instructors in education is that our students have different types of computers with different operating systems, different power, disk capacities, and so on. So in order to standardize, the CIS division partnered with Microsoft to provide a cloud-based solution which has cloud-based machines for our students. The name of this service is the Microsoft Azure Lab Service. Cloud-based simply means you can access it via the internet. For a single course like CIS2103, these cloud-based computers are exactly the same for all students. So, standardization problem solved. The machine you will be using in CIS2103 is basically a Windows 10 machine. Students can access these cloud-based machines via the internet, and this is how. Step 1, you will receive a registration email from Microsoft. The email will have your machine, username, and password. If you haven't received one yet, please check with your instructor. Step 2, you will click the link in the email to access the lab services via your web browser. When prompted to enter your username and password, please enter your college credential. That means your student ID and college password. Step 3 is to access the actual machine via a remote desktop utility. And I will demonstrate this very shortly. However, before I demonstrate, I want to highlight one more thing. Since this course is an introduction to security, you will be using a very useful toolbox called Kali Linux. Basically, Kali is a Linux operating system. It's a Linux distribution that has many, many security tools. In order to practice, you will also need a target computer where you can send viruses, for example, or you can attempt to hack. We will be using Windows XP. Now, can you guess where these two machines will be? They will be pre-installed inside your main course machine as VMs. So in case you're wondering, yes, you can have a VM inside a VM. So on with the demo. Okay, in step 1, a registration email similar to this one was sent to you. It has the cloud machine username and password. When you click the register for the lab button, you will go to the lab services website where you will need to log in with your college student ID and password. This takes us to the second step, the lab services webpage. Here you can see your virtual machines. Some courses have a dedicated machine like CIS2103, others don't. So you might see only one for your course. I have three machines as you can see. For each machine, you can see the name, the number of hours allocated to you, and the number of hours used so far. Don't worry, because this is plenty and no student or even faculty has exceeded the allocated hours yet. The machine will time out and shut down if you are not using it. So every time you need to use a machine, you need to come to this page and turn it on. I recommend you bookmark this page. The bottom part of the machine panel has three clickable items. The on-off button. I started my CIS2103 machine as soon as I got to this page because it takes approximately 5 minutes to boot up. If you have an exam requiring the cloud machine, please ensure you run it before. You will also see the computer icon which will turn from gray to blue once the machine is on. This is the remote desktop file that will allow us to connect to the machine. And finally, the three dots in the right corner is where the RDP information is available in case you need to copy it for whatever reason. At this point, if you are a Mac user, you will need to download the Microsoft Remote Desktop Utility from the App Store. If you are a Windows user, this step is not required. Okay, my machine is up and running, so I will proceed with the third step. I will go ahead and click the computer icon here. This downloads a remote desktop file, go ahead and click it. You will be prompted to enter the machine username and password. These are the ones in the email message you receive. Ignore the digital certificate warning and click continue. And voila, you are connected. This is my Windows 10 cloud machine. Within my machine, remember that I have two other VMs, Kali Linux and Windows XP. To access them, I will double click my Hyper-V hypervisor. And as you can see here, Kali Linux and Windows XP, where you can turn them on and off and manage. This is it for this video. Thank you for watching.